All right, what is going on, ladies and gentlemen? How is it going? I'm Is There No Notes, and I'm on the PTS, and wanted to show a couple things because I've been reading some comments about my Circle of Protection video, and, you know, not gonna lie, like some people, let's just say that there's two different sides to that video, and I kind of feel the same way, you know, obviously, because, you know, I play a lot of Nightblade, and I also play a bunch of other classes, and so, you know, as always, like, I feel like I have a unique perspective in that I do play every class and I try to play every class pretty consistently. So that we all have bias, you know, we all have inherited bias, but I try to not be as biased. Like, I really attempt to do my best to look at it from a bunch of different classes. And so I'm going to look at the Circle of Protection change for you guys, and I'm going to try and provide as much of my unbiased opinion on both sides as possible in this video. And hopefully I can just get my thoughts out there for you guys. And, you know, maybe we can, you know, look this over and, you know, kind of come to our thoughts on it. But essentially, for those of you guys that didn't watch the video, I totally get it. The Circle of Protection morph of to turn evil is now an AoE fear. And so upon activation, enemies in the area are feared for 5 seconds. So you can drop this on the ground. It fears anybody in the area for 5 seconds. And so the discussion is, now every stam tune has access to fear. And, you know, Nightblades are, in my opinion, justifiably a little annoyed, because fear is one of the Nightblade class skills. It is a class, it has for a long time been a class specific skill, and now they've given it to everybody. And so I can understand that feeling that, you know, okay, well, one of the things that made Nightblade unique was its ability to use fear, and now everybody has it, you know. And honestly, this might have a bigger radius than fear. I guess I'd have to go look and double check, but I don't know for sure, but this is a pretty big area. And so anybody that's on top of you, you can now fear them, and so everybody has access to it. So I get it. I totally get it. I get that feeling. I kind of felt the same way as well, because it's like, you know, fear is like one of those, it's one of those skills. Like, you know, if you look at a Nightblade, and what do you think? You think, you know, cloak, you think fear, shadow image, you know, spectral bow. Those are probably like the four biggest skills. It would be like if all of a sudden they took the Fighters Guild skill line and they provided a purify that can purify 5 dots. And I'm not talking about Purge, you know, because Purge is not nearly as good as a Templar Purify. I'm talking about a stamina-based Purge that allows you to purge 5 damage over time effects. If that happened, I feel like Templars would feel the exact same way. Or if they provided a Dark Deal, a stamina-based Dark Deal, Stamsorks would be like, what the fuck? Like, you don't give us any spammable, and you're going to take away our one good, unique skill and give it to everybody? What's the point in playing Stamsork? I could go on with all the classes. Those are just the examples that came to top my off the top of my head. But you get my point. I hope you get my point. But, you know, these class specific skills are have always been, you know, and I think this is the difference between the old combat development team and the new one. And so the old combat development team was, hey, we want DKs to be tanky and dish out like dot damage. We want Sorks to have mobility and high burst and tankiness and survivability and high sustain and high damage and fucking everything. And we want Nightblades to have ridiculous burst but be squishy. You know, they everybody had kind of these like roles and these defined like ideas for what each class was. And the new combat team is assessing the problems with those roles. And they are looking at things that are problematic in a combat situation, and you know, obviously not all of you guys that are watching this video are friends with me in the game, but I have had, it's my belief in this game that if developers looked at this game from it for PvP, I'm not talking about PvE, I'm just talking about from a PvP perspective, if they looked at combat from a one-on-one perspective, and they started to balance the game from that for single target abilities. Obviously, like group Zerg v Zerg or group v group is different, but if they started addressing just simple nuances in combat that come into play, they would make the game a lot better. And one of the nuances that come into play, guys, oftentimes, is not having a CC that can go through block. And so oftentimes, this is, you know, anytime I duel one of my buddies that's a Magplar and I'm on my Magicka DK, the fight just goes on forever. Because, you know, I have most, you know, this was a couple years ago. We're just going to talk about a couple years ago Magic DK. We're not talking about now where they have the buffed whip. We're talking about before they gave them that extra burst damage that they needed. And obviously, I think it's overtuned, so they're scaling it back. I digress. But my point is back in the day, you had all these dots, and Magicka DK was like this dot you down, wear you out, you know, kind of exhaust your resources. You knew you were dying to a Magicka DK essentially before you died because they would just drain you of everything. Stamina, Magicka, whatever. However, a Templar, because you didn't have really any burst back then, a Templar could just go, okay, well, you applied your Burning Embers, you applied your Burning Breath, you locked me in Talons, purify. Now I'm going to go on the offensive. And so you couldn't really do a bunch of burst. And so a well-played Magplar back in the day and a well-played Mag DK, you know, that fight could essentially go on for 45 minutes or forever, like basically until somebody gets bored, because neither side had the tools to kill the other person. And so the developers, the new combat team saw that, and they provided an increased, better whip. And so now Magicka DKs have those dots with a little bit more burst damage, and now they can deal with those tankier, purifying Templars a little bit more easily. Obviously, it can still be a long fight, because Templars, it always can be a long fight, but that's just one of those things. Now, if you're a Templar, you know, back in the day, a Magicka Templar or Stamina, and you're fighting a Magicka DK, you have the same problem. Because you do not have a CC that goes through block. And so you can apply your entire thing, your entire combination, your entire burst combo, you can drop your ult, and they could just go, you know what, I'm just going to block because there's nothing you can do about it. And so essentially they eat all the damage, and then they hold block, and then they go back on the offensive, and they hit their Burning Embers once, and their health is back to full. And you're sitting there frustrated because you're just hitting an immovable wall that has a bunch of points and a block cost, and you're just like, okay, well, this is bullshit. Like, I can't do anything unless you let go of block, and you're not going to let go of block because you're a fucking Magicka DK. And so my long-winded point when I get to all this, guys, is there are class-defining skills, but then there are also skills that, in my opinion, need to be universal in PvP for people to have access to. And I think AoE fear is one of them. And so, yes, it is kind of shitty that Nightblades now have lost their identity of being able to, like, they lost one of their, you know, stapled skills. But this skill should be accessible in one way or another to literally everybody in the game, in my opinion. Everybody should have access to a skill that a block cast Tard can't just negate by holding left trigger. You know, there's no, if you don't have counterplay to block, you don't, like, there's no counterplay. And so my reasoning behind it is, guys, they increase this cast time for ultimates. And so now all of these quick burst ultimates to where you could quickly, like, animation cancel this, it doesn't exist anymore. And so we already talked about this in a previous video, but, you know, maybe when people were watching that, they didn't, you know, potentially take this into account. But it's not going to be as easy to land our ultimate in the Scalebreaker DLC as it currently is. So if you're, you know, a Stam DK, you know, and you're using, or a Stam Circle or whatever, and you're using quick animation cancel, Dizzy, Dawnbreakers, that's not going to work next patch. You're going to Dizzy, and then you're going to have 0.4 seconds to cast your Dawnbreaker, which is going to give people enough time to CC break and potentially block. And so having this skill allows you to potentially get off your ultimate. And if this skill did not exist, all of these cast time ultimates wouldn't land nearly as consistently as they currently do. And so when you look at the overall scale of combat, in my opinion, this is just my opinion, you guys can, you know, I am subject to changing my opinion, I am wrong all the time, but in my opinion, because of the cast times for ultimates, because of the need for counterplay, you need to provide the option for classes that don't have unblockable CCs to have this, to get this off, to cast this ultimate. And so that's just my opinion. obviously. And I know I saw one of the comments. I'm not going to call out any names or anything like that. But if people are worried that everybody having an unblockable CC is overpowered, and an unblockable AoE CC is overpowered, and now the game is going to call for nerfs. If everybody having it is overpowered, it is overpowered if Nightblades have it. Okay? So either it's overpowered currently and it needs an adjustment, or it's fine as it is and you're just expanding the toolkit for everybody in the game to be able to get off potential combinations. And so, yes, part of me is like, yeah, you know, it kind of sucks that fear is adjusted. You know, that. But the other part of me is like, okay, for the health of combat and for wanting to use Onslaught and Dawnbreaker and all these other skills, it's going to be so much nicer to just cast this ability, cast your ultimate, or, you know, do your D-swing, whatever, fear, ultimate. And so it's not anything any different than what Nightblades have currently. I like I said, overall, I like the change. I think the change makes a lot of sense. Kind of wish there was a magic-based one, to be honest. But whatever. I know I'm going to get some flack for it, but hopefully I explained my reasoning well. Hopefully, like, I provided you guys some insight for what I'm talking about. But it's just going to give you an option for dealing with everybody. And so, you know, for those classes, you know, that have to use a weapon spammable, you know, like Stamsorks, like, you know, Stam DKs, because they don't have class spammables, and they're sitting there and they're like, well, do I want to go here and do I want to use rapid strikes and do I want to just poke people 1,000 times? Or, you know, and it's a channel, and if I'm in this channel and I get attacked, I can potentially get bursted. Or do I want to go into like Dizzy Swing, which is also a channel, and get bursted, but it has me that nice risk reward of hitting really hard and also CCing? Or do I just go with like, do I go the Psijic skill line, and do I come down here and do I use, you know, do I use Crushing Weapon? And even though light attacks don't currently land in the current meta sometimes in PvP because, you know, the game's so laggy and people aren't where it says they are, and so you'll never get off this Crushing Weapon. Like, there's really no good options sometimes for these spammables, guys. And so having the ability to just say, you know what, we're going to have an AoE CC, and we are going to have a Fighter's Guild spammable that's available there. And so now you have the ability to fear somebody and get off a burst combo. Everybody's going to have this ability. It's the same as Nightblades. Honestly, I think it's fine. So that's going to be my opinion for now. You guys can, you know, provide your reasoning. I know this is obviously a huge shift, but like I said, the cast times to ultimates is what makes this skill kind of a must, in my opinion. Like, that's definitely something that needs to happen, because, you know, the last thing you want to have happen is, you know, you're getting bum rushed by 6 people, and all of a sudden you go to cast your Dawnbreaker, and they all see it, and they all hold block, and nothing happens, and then there's 6 of them with 6 ultimates, and you're like, well, son of a bitch. You know? Like, this wouldn't have happened last patch, because I could have just literally animation canceled my Dawnbreaker and caught him off guard. Well, yeah. That's what it is. Now, they have the choice to rush in on you, knowing that you have this skill that can fear them, and you can just cast that, and you can drop your ultimate. And so, I like it a little bit more. I think it makes sense. So, yeah. That's the end of the video. Hopefully, I explained myself well. Thank you for watching, guys. Have a nice day.